Okay, so he will come to, she, I guess she's always in the medical wing, doing her job, being a doctor. He will make his way there. Oh, this is a good song, it's a vibe. Ooh, sorry, this is such a vibe.
Yeah, welcome to the med wing.
Hey, I'm down with the med wing, bro. My wing is hype. Is it playing this music?
Robbie is now that I have full admin permissions.
All right, so this is after the last RP, which also gives us something to talk about. okay, so he's going to come in, and he's going to be like, he's going to knock on the wall, because I assume the door's open, and he's going to be like, hey, doctor, you got a second?
Always. Come on in. Is there an issue?
No. Trust me, if there was an issue, I'm sure you would know. and then he's about to say something, and then he's like, you see his head kind of bobbing. It's like, what is this? He's like vibing.
You know, some people call it music.
All right. I'm aware in this robotic brain of mine, I have come across music at one point or another. This is just, this is a new one for me.
Hmm. What?
So he does that thing for a second, and I was telling Bree about this, but he plays shit on his face when he doesn't, when he's trying to give context for what he's doing, since he's always doing shit. He basically has whatever the equivalent of Space Shazam playing.
He does Shazam the song.
Yeah, and so he Space Shazams it, and then adds the song, and you can see it on his helmet. And then for a second, he like kind of forgets that he's in the room because he's listening to the song.
It's all good. Right, doesn't say anything. Just bops. Yeah.
And then he's like, "Oh, sorry."
No.
Is this you? Is this one of your? Is this a song from you or someone else? You find this online? What's the deal? He's like really into the song.
No. I've been to more than a few parties, and sometimes. Some places like to chill the mood before kicking everyone out.
Alright. I gotta go to those parties. It's really quietly.
I can take you sometime.
You know, I would not be opposed to that.
Good.
Anyways. Shakes helmet. I came here to thank you. I've done a lot of contract work. I find it important to show that I value the individuals I work with when they're exceptionally exceptional at what they do. I don't think I've really dealt with a medical officer that's hit the same level of efficacy as you.
Oh my.
Now, when it comes to your professional, he says as a pseudo joke.
Oh, there it is.
I'm just saying. He says the hand shrug. Now, I very much appreciate it. Because I, would be dead, probably. Or at least dismembered or injured for a very long time. Assuming someone could drag my mangled body out of any of those situations. Suffice to say, I was not as prepared as I typically am for these situations. So, that's on me. So it's a bit of an apology as well.
Oh.
Medical resources, I know they can... Especially when it comes to fiscally responsible teams, they tend to not be as plentiful. He looks around at the ship.
don't. You don't really need to worry that much about that. I fight Amanda on that every time it comes up in the budget.
Well, I'm glad. But I should not be taking up more resources than necessary. I know you heal me. I know you use your medical expertise on me a lot. Again, I should be more prepared, so it's half a thank you, half an apology, combined to this amalgamation of professionalism, professional courtesy.
Well, no need to apologize. I mean, medical supplies are there to be used in situations where someone gets injured, such as yourself, if you are in need of medical supplies, then I have deemed it worthy enough that you need supplies. So it's not on you.
So there are situations where I wouldn't be deemed worthy.
There are situations where, you know, you don't use a spoon to cut bread or whatever, right?
You know, earlier today, someone told me that my metaphor didn't track. I'm starting to think that I understand what he meant.
Nice.
Yeah, but I get what you're saying.
Don't worry. You're always going to get treatment, but if you're worried about using unnecessary resources, then you don't. Just blame me for that.
So you don't what?
Hmm?
What'd you say? Sorry, say that again.
Oh, you don't have to be sorry about using up unnecessary resources.
Okay.
You should just blame me for that.
You should blame you for that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, I should blame... You're right. I should blame you. So I will provide a report to the captain that you have been wasting resources.
I'm sure he would love a detailed report. Make sure you get it in... I would say triplicate, but Amanda's probably going to want an excuse to talk to Melv and get a copy for herself, so just get duplicate.
And I do think it's very important to give them physical paper, because that way they can highlight specifically the part where you wasted resources
on
me.
Now, do you think it's a yellow highlighter problem or more of a red?
It really depends, right? Mm. Because on certain missions, I know that there was an excessive use when, for example, I lost my leg. It's like no big deal, but you saw it fit to use up a ton of medical resources. So I would put a red highlighter for that one.
Red for that one. Okay.
Yes. I mean, they're all going to be highlighted.
Of course.
Because I have never seen such a gross misuse and lack of understanding of protocol before. So, I mean, I'm glad you and I are on the same page. It's a good thing that, in fact, I think maybe we should get your signature. He has he has like a line up here on his helmet. It's like one of those digital signature screens. So we'll get that. Go ahead, and then
No problem, no problem. You have a stylus, or do I just use my finger?
You can just use your finger.
Okay. Takes like the gloved ones, and you don't want you don't want smudges. I don't want smudges on that helmet.
Don't worry, I got wipes. He takes out a wipe.
Oh, no. I got this. Use the glove, the glove thingies to,
Yeah, of course.
She just puts just draws a very artistic, like, heart on it.
It, like, blocks, and then it goes to the bottom of a paper where you can see he was actually writing the document out. Alright, I'll make sure to send it to you so you can, make sure it covers the exact extent of the gross misconduct that you've been performing.
Oh, sure thing.
And then once you've given the approval on the edits, I'll make sure everyone in the team and the captain and, you know, every single person, the robot he points, can get one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Everyone needs to know.
Of course. Of course.
And then hopefully that'll put a stop to this.
Yeah.
Which something tells me it most definitely won't.
I know. Amanda can push pretty hard.
She is very good at what she does.
Mm-hmm.
You guys have a lot of those. A lot of weirdly good at what you guys do. I would say not to take this offensively, but I know it is just almost certainly going to be because it's pretty rude. But everyone on this ship is way better than I thought they would be at their jobs.
Better than they should be?
No, he said better than I thought they would be.
Oh, sorry. Oh, you had low expectations of us.
I have low expectations. I've been on a lot of ships, and this one, it has the typical pattern. No Siri.
It's just randomly.
Siri goes off.
I think she's getting jealous.
Clearly. He bonks his helmet because the fucking thing doesn't listen, apparently. So, anyways. Yeah, I've been through a lot of ships. And ones that look like kind of grungier. Again, that's not an insult. Most ships are grungy. You know, got that ragtag salvager crew vibe going on. They tend to trip and fire the gun into a wall at war, see a rat, start crying. That was a good one. I did medical on the medical officer on one of them. So you see, like, where, and I'm sure you assume I'm incredible, but surprise, surprise, don't know medical for my life, but I can apply a bandage. I was impressed by this ship. I have been, I am. Now, what comes with that is, surprisingly, we also are dealing with some of the worst and most dangerous and unprepared for missions I've ever seen. Unpreparable for missions. I don't understand. he says in he's not in a flustered way, but he's just like, he's like genuinely confused. Anyways.
Well, yeah. Unlucky? Though, we did do phenomenally enough to get paid. But, all jobs are different. It just so happens that, you got one of those ones.
Yeah, I suppose I got one of those ones. Anyways, I appreciate you taking a second. I don't want to hold more of your time.
I will activate all the time you want. It's not like I'm doing anything else.
Yeah, I suppose. It didn't seem like you were doing much when I came in here. But I do have some menial paperwork to send out. And important mission reports that no one will read. He says very passive aggressively. And then I imagine he was sitting on something or leaning on something. He gets up and he's like, "I appreciate the new song, and thank you again."
Of course.
And then he will. Leave.
There's that.
Okay, RP finished.
It is.
Here it is. You did it.
I need to.